Hey guys, it's Gong Show here. I'm just here to bring you guys a quick little tutorial video, a little noob's guide to Sea of Thieves, if you will. Whenever I run into new pirates on the seas, they're always off doing some random quest at Smuggler's Bay for 25 hours. I'm here to help them make as much money and do it in as little time as possible. Hopefully it helps. Hopefully you guys enjoy the video, but here it goes. So the one thing that I always tell people to do before they even load into the game, before they even pick their pirate, is to go into settings and lower the FOV under the gameplay setting to 60. That will make sure that anything that you shoot at, whether it be a player, a skeleton, a crab, or a fish, or a shark, or whatever you want to shoot at, is as centered on your screen as possible. You have the lowest FOV, so you're pretty much hyper-focused on that item. So next, what I always tell people to do is make sure you do the maiden voyage, because that is how you get all of your starter equipment. So if you just went into adventure, you wouldn't have a compass, you wouldn't have a shovel, you wouldn't have a bucket, you wouldn't have a sword, you wouldn't have a sniper. It would be a very terrible experience. You would just be a naked pirate roaming the seas, and nobody wants that. So once you get your equipment in the maiden voyage, you can just quit out. You don't have to look up any guides. It's pretty self-explanatory. It tells you right where to go. But once you get your bucket and everything, you can just close out of the game, reload in, and then you can go back into adventure. So now we're going to talk about what ship to choose when you load into the Sea of Thieves. So there's three different ships. There's a sloop, a brigantine, and a galleon. The galleon is obviously the big mumba jumba. He's got the four cannons, three masts. It's the hardest to sink. If you're a new pirate, I highly suggest picking galleon, especially if you're alone, because you'll have four different cannons, technically eight cannons, but four on each side, that you can choose from to shoot other ships. You don't have to worry about getting in the way of anybody. There's going to be no crewmates that get in your way. There's going to be no crewmates that mess up. It's all on you. Also, the sloop has one mast, so if somebody hits a chain shot on one mast, you can't move anymore. They double board you, and you would die. Just to add on to that, the galleon is also the easiest ship to maneuver. It's the fastest ship in the game if you have full wind, so galleon is the clear choice. Just to add on to that, the galleon is also the easiest ship to maneuver. It's the fastest ship in the game if you have full wind, so galleon is the clear choice. As far as emissaries go, the Reapers are probably the easiest to represent. Nobody goes after Reapers because they figure they're newer players. And also, that's the highest reward for the lowest amount of risk, because you can level up your flag really easily. And like I said, nobody really messes with you because they just assume you're a newer player. Clothing in this game is pretty much all cosmetic except for the crab outfit. The crab outfit will actually give you better stats. It'll make you run a little bit faster. Your accuracy is up. And then on the flip side, if you equip the crab cosmetics onto your ship, it will give you minus wind resistance. So no matter what direction the wind's going, your ship will be moving the fastest that it possibly can. So that skull in the sky is the end game. You can only get there if you get 75 in all of your factions. I touched on this earlier, but this is where you would change out your equipment so you can get better items. Equipment is not just cosmetic, so what you can do is you'll get the base sailor stuff from the maiden voyage, but over time you'll get more gold and you can upgrade your items to like better shovels, better compasses, better buckets, so you can bucket water a lot quicker. The better shovels, obviously, you dig up a chest. It can actually dig up an Athena in one swing. Before you guys set sail, you're going to probably want to use the bathroom. So when you spawn into this tavern here, you're just going to want to make sure you pull out some sort of musical instrument. And then you can play this tune in this spot right here, and it will unlock the bathroom door. So you just go downstairs. You just got to make sure it's cool with the bartender. You just go downstairs and you can use the bathroom so that your bathroom meter does not get full right off the bat. Don't worry about meeting new players right away, because before you hit level 10, you're on AI servers. All ships are generated by Rare. You're not going to come across any real players, so you can just go right up to them and, steal all their stuff. And what I mean by level 10 is if you go into the menu and go into your reputations, the numbers that you see here that are 75, they need to be 10 before you unlock true PvP servers. I can't believe I almost forgot, but to unlock the crab outfit, you guys have to go to the Shores of Gold store. It's located in the far northeast of the map. It's going to look like it's like in a darkened area, but there's going to be little squiggly lines with a little skull over the top of it. Don't worry, it's easy to get to. You just sail to it. It's not a big deal. But if you see red water, that means you're going the right way, but this is what the store looks like. Now I'm going to show you guys how to make a lot of money in this game if you're a new player. Where you want to go is far east to what's called the Devil's Roar. The islands are really close together, not like the rest of the map where they're all spaced out. They're all going to be to the right of those circles. That place up to the right up there, up to the northeast, that's the shores of Gold Store that I was telling you about earlier. But if you look, that Molten Sands Fortress is probably the best fort in the game. It's the easiest one to do, and there's really, you know, no risk, high reward in the Devil's Roar. You can kind of leave your ship and go do your questing and do whatever you need to do. Now we go to the armory, where you can upgrade your weapons. You start off with a standard metal sword. You upgrade them here and there to just different metal swords. The gold one will break in combat, so you don't really want to use that one, because being without a sword is kind of pointless in this game. What you want to use is the ashen sword. It's made of fire, and it can also cut through other people's swords and cut through other people's guns. It will render them completely useless. So people always talk about the different snipers in this game. I personally like the Fearless Bone Crusher Eye of Reach. I don't think it takes up that much room on the screen, so you still have like full visibility of your enemies. Speaking of weapons that do not take up a lot of room and that are super accurate, I personally love this new pistol. It's the Pistol of Sunken Sorrow. I think it's the best pistol in the game. It's got super nice accuracy, and the gun just has a clean, clean iron sight. Just a little footnote while I end things and wrap things up here. If you guys are trying to do PvP, make sure you guys aim for the head. It does the most damage. And also, if you guys are new to PvP, do not use a sniper sword, because that's for pro players. Please try using like a pistol blunderbuss for newer players. It's going to do the most damage, but make sure you aim for the head. But yeah, that's the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys learned a lot from this video. If you guys want, hit me up on Twitch. It's at, you know, X Gong Show. On Twitter as well, same thing. Everything's the same pretty much. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, you know, give it a like, share it with your friends, let everybody know that these are the necessities of Sea of Thieves. And also make sure that everything that I said in this video, you just absolutely forget. Do not follow any of my instructions that I told you here today. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.